Next up is our eye and ear medication. So for eye medication, we have acetazolamide, given to lower pressure inside the eye by decreasing the secretion of fluid in the eye itself, like with glaucoma patients. So ATI mentions the indication for this drug is chronic open-angle glaucoma, and the key patient teaching was to report paresthesia in the facial regions, to report these to the HCP immediately. So remember, we're reporting numbness, tingling, and even burning feeling around the mouth, tongue, or lips. Now, the big contraindication here is an allergy to sulfa drugs. So Kaplan mentioned acetazolamide is a contraindication for sulfa allergies. Now, a big side note here, we avoid all anticholinergics with any patient with glaucoma. So the top four anticholinergics are atropine, benzotropine, ipratropium, and oxybutynin. These are the top four anticholinergic drugs on five different question banks. And they all cause the body to be dry. So think anticholinergic means anti-secretions, causing a very dry body, which can cause major damage with patients with glaucoma. So remember, if it causes the dry, then avoid the glaucoma of the eye. Now, as far as eye medication administration, this came up a few times on various question banks. So the big four tips to know and write these down, we're going to cover them. So tip number one, we drop the medication into the conjunctival sac, never directly into the eye itself. That's a big no-no. So we never touch the tip of the dropper directly onto the eye. This can not only cause damage to the eye itself, but can also introduce infection to the dropper. Now, tip number two, we gently close and rotate the eyes around after administration. Keyword here is we never rub the eye after administration. So, no rubbing here. Now, number three, this is a huge key point. We always apply gentle pressure to the corner of the canthus duct to prevent rapid absorption of the medication into the eye duct, which can go systemic to the entire body. Now, this is really good when we're giving timolol, that beta blocker that helps the eye. We want to prevent the systemic beta blocker going into the entire body. So we cover that little eye gutter called the canthus. And with this, we never wipe the eye from out to in, kind of like how we do with UTIs. Again, this can not only cause rapid absorption of the med, but can also introduce infection into the duct. Now lastly, number four, we always wait 5 minutes before placing another medication into the same eye. Now guys, write these down because these were the top four test tips for eye medication administration. Now as far as ear medication administration, the top four key points here is number one, we always put the affected ear up, either tilt the head or lay down with that affected ear to the sky. And number two, we straighten that ear canal. So the key terms to know for the NCLEX is the adults, you pull up and out, and for the child, you pull down and back. These two come up time and time again as test questions. So guys, write those down. Now, always remain tilted or side-lying for at least 2 to 5 minutes to help the medication absorb into that ear. And number three here, the big no-nos to maintain safety. Just like the eye, we never touch the dropper into the ear itself, which can penetrate the ear and could cause damage. And lastly, number four, a little side note here. We keep the medication warm or at room temperature, kind of like how we do an enema. So remember, we don't administer anything cold into the body. All right, guys, that wraps it up for this segment. Don't forget to take your quiz and download the study guides.